So I guess it doesn't matter much.
I guess it kind of depends what your game plan going into this is. Having this
Yeah.
mid lane, Sinnoh could try to go for something here, but
He's just getting harassed.
it's very even in
Genji
the
is
lane so
actually getting
far.
harassed a lot. He has got a salve, but I think Genji knows that there's no rune there, and actually they're gonna go for this one. Rook in a lot of trouble. Oh! First off, by Yasuo coming in with a zap just in time. Queen of Pain has blinked himself away, or at least tried to, and then killed herself off on the Ancients. Which is just making sure that he's barely showing himself on lane, getting most of his experience from sacrifice and maybe heals here and there. Because he is the one, he knows he is the one that would die if they get a kill there, if they get a success. We go around
oh.
as Rook just jumped himself into Sinnoh. He'll end up dying this time.
Will you not?
Just
oh.
really wanted to get the rune. Didn't think that Vengeful Spirit was sitting around there. In the meantime, bottom lane had Shadow Shaman die. Also, so Sinnoh didn't just pop the stat again
attack.
On the top lane. Invis rune coming out, and no vision for what kind of rune it was for I Love Mama Boys, but they should be able to tell it was an active rune. They know it was an active rune, so they should be extra careful. The one
bottom
charge for Puck has got a Dream Coil available. Clockwork still indeed gets a kill there. We're gonna follow this action right here. Sax goes in with the target. He knows he's dead. Yeah, okay. Well, this is very anticlimactic. He should have followed bot lane. How did Axel get that kill? You see it.
He played very aggressively.
Doesn't look like it doesn't want to go anymore. Do a risky target to go for on a Queen of Pain. In the meantime, wrap around. Yeah, looks for a crush, finds it on the art style, but he cold feet still there. Oh. Will proc maybe as well? Is the shackle? Then will not proc actually. Shackle on art style will get a kill there. And did you wrap rotated bottom? Farm is now forced back on the tower. In the meantime, Queen of Pain. I mean,
afterward.
If Dendi would have gotten the kill, or if nobody would
yeah,
have died.
Yeah, if Dendi had gotten the kill, because
oh,
even though
different.
Dendi died, he actually dominated the lane afterwards for a few minutes.
Got for Dendi and Sinnoh. Flare coming in, hookshot as well. Up on Hook, he's trying to blink away, but the Dream Coil and the Silence are there. That is a nice kill going away of Dendi. And he's one step closer to his blink tag. Objectives, because they're playing into the late game, they're like, you know, we have Spectres, so we're fine. Oh, Flare coming out. They know this is happening right now. Are they gonna be able to take it fast enough? The Doom is there as a meat shield. They're gonna be able to take it fast enough. And
they're
not gonna be able to reply and have the Hunt come out to Slaughter.
Radiant's top tower.
Takes the Aegis and Spectres is haunted into a Doom.
I'm very surprised this
should be. Yeah. Sinnoh will get picked off there as well. They should back off from that tower right now.
Yes.
This
sure.
is not
Art
the
style.
fight
You're
they
dead.
Can take.
Art style, don't.
Did they seem going into the yeah, they did. Okay. Dream Coil still coming out, and they ate all as well. They will be able to take the Aegis and the Lich as well. Yasuo is chased down by Dendi, who still gets hit by the Sonic Wave, but Queen of Pain still dies to the Clockwork. Pykehead coming in with the Blink, looking for a crush, finds it on the Clockwork, but Clockwork not dying anytime soon. Dicharra coming in, back in the fight. Double kill for Axmo, and it is Na'Vi. That has proven that they can definitely fight there under their tower, and it also means that with the kills that Mama Boy had and with the Aegis, they can't
Dire's
take any
tower
towers off the back
attack.
Of that.
Pretty sure this is.
But
they should have seen it. Nobody pinged it out, but I think they should have seen it.
Oh, double damage through for Hook. He's going for Sinnoh, and Sinnoh is visible as he's standing under the ward.
Sucks on mid lane. Dead.
Nope. And Sinnoh's trying to TP out. We're gonna follow this one as Puck. Is or rather, Lich was dying.
And Hook Shit. Going for the Ags. He wants to be able to find these pickoffs more often. If he had his ultimate there, for example, that would have been a kill for sure.
Definitely.
Silence.
Oh,
Dendi jumping on Hook. The Haunt is there as well. They want to take him down. He will be able to. Blink is there, but doesn't matter.
Radiant's top tower.
Blink
out
the Dream Coil. That hurts still. It's a bit of an illusion, but the wards are there, and everybody can just fight around it. Shadow Shaman's dominating streak has now ended. That's what he had. That's a lot of gold going away of the Spectre, by the way, and that alone makes this fight, I think, worth it. Can they find another one?
They don't really have the initiation without the hook shot.
Yeah, but no, Clockwork blinks away.
Then he needs to be closer.
Oh. Then he needs to be very careful. The crush comes out. Axel's still gonna play him off though. That helps him out a lot. In comes the two. Up on the real Dandy. Real Dandy. Real dead. But he is. Queen of Pain coming in to take that kill. Crushed up on Axel again. This time he does not have a blade. But gets swapped into safety by a Sinead. Oh, he's coming up. They might be able to turn this one around. Fox cannot lie back to help you out. Sonic Wave killing off the Vengeful Spirit. Now the hookshot there again. This time going for Bambo. But the Daisy Separation Lord is only level 1 and therefore it ended. And the creeps coming in to help us get the kill on that clockwork, which means Spectre is the only one left alive. Bambo. It's very low, but Spectre's already gone. Still got the kill on the Slardar though, and these two. At least two.
Yeah, so this is something that you don't want to happen again. I think this is the biggest priority right now.
Well, smoke up from Mama's boys. With the Shadow Blade also coming out, the vision there, they look for the dead. Oh, the silence just in time, but the top there is not Bambo. Can he get the two round? I think he can. Mitchell will not bounce around. Deadly dodging that one as well. Shimeko making himself first because he got that Sonic Wave in the face. Looking for Hook, has got another stun in a second. We'll be able to use it up on Hook. There he goes, and that's a kill right there as well. The smoke up from Mama's boys blowing up in their face. He actually let him out. He did kill off one of the wards, thinking he might not have him, but Bambo will go down there. Nice swap. Trying to get Saksa as well. It's an infinite turn to a chicken. The Hodge is there, though, helping out, killing off Saksa, and perhaps Jaxter there as well. So that is two supports that are very, very dead as Zeddy comes in. Double kill for Hook, though. He was able on the backline kill off two supports of his own. Bitter off. He is the person that I don't think they want to see fall at smoke. Trying to get away. He's got 2400 gold. We'll do quite a bit. Start buying your items, son. You need to get some extra action. Buy your items!
Did he? He did.
Thank you. He actually
it was
a lot of perseverance, though.
Yeah, it was a panic buy.
Explos hoop, so he can't jump yet. Doesn't need to, though. BKB pop from Pika, though. The swap's still there. Can they take him down? That's why damage up on Dendy, who gets hexed up straight away. In comes Room, Mama's voice. Oh, Dendy's already down. Becker's down on Axel. I'm not sure if that's gonna do a lot there. As we have got Navi on the retreat, DJRA getting doomed up, won't be able to do anything anymore, and they are looking for Arcel. Arcel and Clockwork, the only one left. Axmo is on the Dire Jungle at this point, and Arcel will die. But Clockwork does not have a teleport score. They have to fight damage up, there's still smoke on the rest though. Please care for a Pushel coming out as well. And the crush, and then they go dead. Well, it's the only one dying, I say, yeah. Liberation teleporting out. Spectre teleporting out. Exmo has not got any mobility items apart from the hookshot, but he will be okay. It's a good thing that they only got Sinead there. It could have been way worse.
Yes.
But Sinead is dead for only 30 seconds, so he'll be okay.
Ake is gonna drop in 2 minutes. I don't think Mama's boys will be able to utilize it for the push too much. I think Navi has enough to wait it out.
Oh, the heck, they are actually going straight away. They go on Battle first, so there as well. Yaptor picked up Sonic Wave, still doing some damage, but it's not enough. Still bouncing around to Giraffe, force back, and actually goes on to work on the wars. Pikat still has that Aegis, and we'll be using it right there. And then he will use the time to try and take out Saksa. Or is he? No, he's just focusing on Pikat. He was up in the air first. BKB is there, so I'm not sure if that's a nice swap, but it's a swap nonetheless. Pikat backing off.
Boom! There it goes!
They're coming out, actually. Flare breaks up. Saksa and Dendy jumping forward, hexing up Pikat. Is there backup? No. Queen of Pain should be okay as well. Still has a BKB and can blink out. Yeah, but the BKB is there. Oh, and he misses the hookshot as well. Oh, he's up in the air. Now the BKB should come out. There you go. BKB teleport out. And Dendy is going to die. Who cancels this TP because he knows maybe he can make something happen. A gem picked up by Axmo. Can they chase down Pikat? Pikat has got another blink. Yeah, he dead. Very dead. Let's try to. Well, tower down, lift down. Move. He does have a buyback, but I don't think it matters much. Ooh. Blink in, hex up on Hook. They keep finding these pickups. The Hook shot in the meantime coming out as well. Hit on a creep, but it doesn't matter. Hook will be able to blink away, but it's still getting chased. There could be a Yules if Danny wants to make it happen. He has got the Yules there as well. Is there enough fall up there? Oh, nice cog placement and a silence and a kill. Well done. Navi, they're just taking advantage of monkey business, basically. Seeming to.
Navi, you commit to at least tower pushes.
Another BKB, some top is there. Hook. You can blink again though, do something. There should be enough damage, Echo Shell or not. Echo Shell is actually up on Axel himself. Tier 2 tower drops. And they found Pycat.
And
they
force another BKB.
Nice blink. That Doom is in the meantime. Doom does not have a BKB up yet. The Upsher doesn't even have a BKB. Does have a gem. It falls behind the tree line though, so they don't. Yeah, they do see it. Yeah. So Neko picks it up. And they are kind of locked in right now. Rush coming in. Up on the Neko. They jump to the top. And everybody is split. Yeah, their Pyke is still getting high stuff, but Force tosses himself to the low ground. Dendi looking for the kill. The Hookshot actually already found it though. And there is the Vengeful Spirit down on the deck with the gem as well as Mamo just crushes her down. The wards are there. Fading the fight again back to the wards, but I don't think it matters. That is just free gold. Although, actually, Puck! Dendi just died to those wards. And Saksa is the last one alive on the side of. That was a bit BS.
Alright, this was the least tactical pause ever. They can just focus again, yeah, for sure. But they also expended a ton of BKB charges right now.
Yep. Oh, Mama's voice. This is the final hurrah, the last Hail Mary. Dira, focus upon the jump already bouncing around. There is a death on the neck on the front that actually hits 3 people, 2 people at least, actually. Maybe just one, I don't even know, but it's enough. Axmo, together with Denny, last one alive. Dira, Aegis is burned, back off alive, but doomed up already, but the desolate damage, oh my god! I really thought that Mama's boys had this fight. I really thought they had a chance. They started out so well, but then Aegis just turned everything around.
They also clumped up together for a very beautiful A blast. I think it hit 2 in the blast and clipped another 2 with the shatter effect.
I got caught up on that Sonic wave, but I thought it was really good, but then I failed, figured there was only one person that could hit Dire's bottom tower. And it doesn't even matter, Dijera, he's got 10k gold.
He has 10k gold in his bank, and he doesn't even need to spend it at this point.
No. GG, that's it.
GG is called. And,
well, after that pause,
Monster kill!
I don't know. That was very anticlimactic. No,